Every possible scenario has a scripted response readily available. Since I've already gone through the training, I'll show you the ropes. Let's do this first one together.
Okay.
This one, yes. Pure Hotline, we care.
Yo, do you have Prince Albert in a can?
Sugar Daddy, stop cranking us.
Yo, how'd you know it was me?
Yo, I don't know.
Oh, give me that phone. Sugar, you leave poor Brookie alone. Now that she's dumped Nick as her best friend, she needs her private time to reflect on her new independent lady life and the Air Maze riding saddle I gave her this morning.
Hey, Mary Terry, now that I've got you on the line, I don't have a horse.
All in time, new best friend for life. All in time. Bye, hun. See you at lunch.
Pure Hotline, we care.
I don't know what to do. I just can't take it anymore.
Just relax, we're here to help.
I can't sleep. I can't eat. School's become a never-ending nightmare.
Okay, what's going on? Tell us.
I'm being tortured. Today I was called a Rose of Sharon. Yesterday it was Morning Glory. The day before, Daffodil.
Okay, what part of this botanical torture do you find so unbearable?
Don't you get it? It's not about the flowers. This person is insinuating that I'm gay. If I was, I'd laugh it off, but I'm not. And now everyone thinks I am. It's like my choice has been taken away.
Look, we can stop him. Just tell us who it is. We can go to Principal Hall and...
I'm not gonna narc. No way. That'll just make it worse. I feel so trapped.
Something. I don't know.
I knew this was a bad idea. It's hopeless. I'm just not sure how much longer I can go on.
Okay, but... Did you hear his voice? He was terrified. Can you believe how cruel guys are? God, does testosterone erode brain cells?
You know what it is? It's just obviously some sick, insecure self-loathing.
Me too, look.
Loser.
Twice will last the longest in this life. Character or rock hard fight. In the end, do you believe that beauty lies in what you see? Cause if you do, then baby, you've been deceived. Well, me.
Just getting in the mood for the annual Ford family fishing expedition.
Thank you.
Oh, I wanted to talk to you about that. I don't really feel up to it this year.
Oh, no, Mom. No sitting in the cabin reading back issues of McCall's. This year, you're going to be out on the boat, and you're going to be reeling them in with the boys.
I think I'm coming down with something.
Mom, you've used that excuse 2 years in a row. Now, come on, you're going.
Look, I'll even clean the fish this time. You just have to go. What else could possibly stand in your way?
I'm leaving your father, Josh. I'm moving out. It's been a long time coming. I can't take it anymore. I feel like I'm drowning in this house.
Has he hit you?
Oh, no. No, of course not. Josh, abuse doesn't have to be just physical. Can also be emotional.
You want to show me you're strong? Then you give him an... Mom, give this family another chance. For me. I'll help you. Please?
Much, isn't it?
I've just never seen a handkerchief double as a blouse before.
Come on,
This is less revealing than what, like, 90% of girls on television wear. Mm-hmm. Besides, it makes me feel saucy.
Hey, Carm. New highlights?
Wow, she's being nice.
Yeah, she's only being nice to me after a year of hell because she needs a new friend. You know, to replace the only one she's ever had.
Nicole, we need to talk.
Brookie, you know, I've been upset too since we've been catfighting. Yesterday I crashed and wore this pashmina shawl, and it wasn't until second period that I awoke from my pity coma and realized, yeah, hi, they've been out since January.
Look, what I want to talk to you about is Freddie Gong. It's got to stop with him, Nicole. I mean, you're really hurting him, and I'm not going to tolerate that.
And you're going to take Spam's word for it? Or Spam the only one who will sit by and listen to you whine without barfing? Oh, of course she can't escape. She lives with you.
What happened to you? You were so nice for a while after Christmas, and then...
Yeah. And then Carmen quit the Glamazons, plopping a public return-to-sender stamp on my generosity, thus proving that compassion gets you nothing but egg on the face. And frankly, if I'm in the mood for a skin-tightening mask, I'm going the Kiehl's route, hun. Loyalty is clearly not rewarded.
Loyalty? Is that what you call sleeping with my boyfriend?
Ex-boyfriend, come on, Brookie, you shoved him off your plate.
Yeah, and the little dog under the table wasted no time gobbling up all my scraps.
Listen, you want to dump me as your best friend despite the fact that I've walked over broken glass for you barefoot, fine. But honey, you may fool everyone else, not me. I know you all too well, my little passive-aggressive one.
I want you to stop picking on Freddy. You got it? It isn't cool.
Listen, Princess Grace.
Oh, God.
I'm just reinforcing the social order that you started. You know, until having a conscience became fashionable. And FYI, hypocrite. Remember Homecoming? Until 2 months ago, you didn't even know Freddie Gong's name. Come on, Mary Cherry, let's go to lunch.
Oh, I'd love to, Nick, but Brookie hates her guts. This means you're unpopular now, the social kiss of death. Now, I can never be seen publicly with you again for as long as I live. Hey. Guess who's out back right now chewing grass behind the bleachers?
You didn't just get me a horse.
Yes, come on, come on!
Mary. I'm leaving your father, Josh. I'm moving out.
All three.
Yo, bro, you gotta play Harrison's game, man. Come on, Harry, son!
Okay, Josh. Who would you kick out of bed? Bioglass or Nurse Jessie?
Neither. Who could pass up?
A glass is the three.
Oh, oh, you have a motherfucking freak on, yeah! Oh,
man!
Yo, is it chilly in here today or what?
Oh. Damn, Lily, where have you been hiding those?
Oh, come on, we were just surprised. We didn't think you could look so sexy.
Don't. That's so not cool.
Okay.
Harrison, are you gonna let them talk to me like that?
Come on, Lil, lighten up. We're just having fun. You look great. You should be flattered.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, whatever.
What's up with her?
I can't turn her in, Sam. And besides, I feel hypocritical enough as it is.
I know you may have done some pretty heinous things in your time, but I doubt sadistic homophobic outbursts are among your crimes.
Ignoring them is. Look, I can't help thinking that I could have somehow stopped this.
Brooke, we have an obligation.
Freddie called in anonymously, remember? He doesn't want to come forward, so how can we make that choice for
Look,
him?
Pure hotline, we care.
Hi. I'm calling because I've been sexually harassed by boys at this school. I've received lascivious stares, lewd comments, and unwanted touches.
Lily, is that you?
Yeah.
Mr. Bernardino, do you deny lewdly commenting on the temperature? I'll take your silence as acquiescence. And Mr. Ford, do you deny leering at and then subsequently fondling Miss Esposito?
Fondling?
I didn't do that. I put my arm around him because I felt bad about what I said. That's harassment?
Yes, it is, Mr. Ford.
Principal Hall, why am I here?
Apathy and callous indifference, Mr. John, are symptomatic of deeper sensitivity problems that need to be dealt with. Gentlemen, since you do not deny these charges, I am forced to give you a choice. 2 weeks suspension, which will go on your records.
We have to send those to colleges.
Or enrollment in a new sensitivity camp to be conducted this weekend on school grounds.
Principal Hall, does it have to be this weekend? My family planned this fishing trip.
The fishies can wait, Mr. Ford. Your social education cannot. The way you treat girls today wholly determines the way you treat women tomorrow.
It's a Clydesdale, just like in those beer commercials.
She's beautiful.
Why are we sitting with Mary Cherry? Isn't that one of the signs of the impending apocalypse?
Now, I heard that, Lil Lily, but I hold no grudge. I've decided to become a student advisor at the sensitivity camp. But to make sure that this new program is effective, I'll need a partner to help me implement all the many important facets of my feminist manifesto.
Mary Cherry? Metaphorical castration and the taming of the teenage boy.
Mm-hmm. I feel it's my duty as Brookie's potential future maid of honor to combat a new foe. The hostile, male-dominated society where no female can feel safe from the sweaty stares of the male harasser beast.
Wow, you know what, Mary Cherry? I never thought I'd say this, but you're really starting to make sense.
Hey, Brookie, would you join me? Here, look, I got a serious feminist eyeglass as a Gucci, so we'd look the part.
Let me see.
I will join you, Mary Cherry. I think what you're doing is important.
Wait. Good for you, Carmen. United we stand.
But, Rick, I thought that you and I, you know, you and I doing this would make us, like, best friends.
But Mary Cherry, you are getting all of us motivated. That's awesome. You and Carmen are going to make a great team. I'm really proud of you.
Oh, okay. Great. Me and Carmen. Together. It's a real treat. Oh, well, hey, fellas. Did you hear? They're doing a casting call for the sequel to The Accused. Yeah, you guys are shoo-ins.
Okay, why are we being singled out?
You guys totally violated Lily in so many ways. How can you not see that?
See what? Are we all just being a bit hypersensitive here? Lil?
You didn't stand up for me, Harrison, and that hurt.
Maybe you shouldn't have come in dressed like that.
A girl should be able to wear whatever she wants without fear.
Lil, love ya, but face the facts. If you didn't want the attention, you wouldn't have dressed like that.
There is a big difference between attention and abuse, Harrison.
Yeah, and who gets to decide what that is?
We do!
Whatever.
Whatever. You know, Pansy, you're one rib tea away from touring with Madonna. So, I understand that you've decided to open your big fat mouth and tell Brooke and Spam of our special relationship.
I didn't say anything. Now leave me alone.
Oh, my little sunflower, that's not gonna happen. Now that my little petal boy's narked me out and made my social status even more precarious, my little petal boy's gonna pay. Buckle up, Fredrika.
You had no right to expose me to Nicole. Do you understand what you two just did to me? My life is over. Over.
You know what you have to do.
God, it's no big deal. Guys and girls have been acting like this forever.
Josh, the reason I'm disturbed with you is not just because of what you did, but that you can't seem to understand why it was wrong. You know what the scary thing is, Josh? You're behaving exactly like your father.
My father has nothing to do with what happened at school. And don't even think about using that as an excuse to get out of this trip, Mom.
I'm not doing this trip. This trip is now officially canceled.
Mom! Look, you have to go. This is just what you two need, okay? Dad only gets his cabin one weekend out of the year, Mom. And it means so much to him. I know things are gonna get better.
I'll go. But only if you do something for me, Josh. You go on this retreat, and you promise me you take it seriously. Okay? Promise?
I promise.
All right, fellas, let's gather around. Now comes the hard part. You're all due for a piece of the rock. It is my privilege to introduce to you your sensitivity enforcer, my brother, a former Marine gunnery sergeant, and the best damn shift manager Target has ever seen. Rock Glass!
Don't you eyeball me, boy! When I'm through with you three disrespecters of women, glass ceilings will be shattered. Personal space will be respected. How am I gonna make you shining examples of male enlightenment? I have a three-pronged plan! Prong one, let's get physical! Wherein I will systematically test your stamina. For as the body breaks, the mind opens. Prong two, with your newly opened minds, we will, through daytime talk show caliber role-playing exercises, break you down mentally! And then finally, the most important prong, healing! You will feel, you will share. So, I ask you, are you ready to get sensitive? I can't hear you. Are you ready to get sensitive?
Sir, yes, ma'am.
Sir,
ma'am, sir,
ma'am.
Yes.
Shut up!
Sorry.
Someone's missing. There's supposed to be four of you.
Sugar, grab my bags.
Okay. Wow. Okay. Well, I'm going to need a top bunk and a screen and a thread count above room temperature. Hi, sweet sugar.
Tardiness is not acceptable. Know what I did to little troublemakers like you in Kuwait? Fried them up with a little napalm. Made myself a snack.
Okay. All right. Well, now, see, look around. Okay? Does it look like I belong here?
No.
Ah, Private Benji. You look almost like a soldier.
And you look almost like a man.
You will submit to me.
Never.
You will do as you are told. You will run, you will jump, you will eat all the carbs on your plate. And by the end of this weekend, you will feel...
Bring it on.
Present goals! You will learn to respect women and people whose lifestyles are different than yours. Every time that doll touches the ground, you can add another lap. Ready to jog, recruits? Dolls up. Let's go. I don't know, but I've been told.
I don't know, but I've been told.
Respect for others never gets old.
Respect for others never gets old.
Sound off.
One, two.
Sound off.
Three, four.
Sound off.
One, two, three, four.
Two, three, four.
We need to show you something.
Look.
Let's go.
Since you came forward, the hotline has been ringing off the hook about tons of guys at school. Girls are no longer afraid, Lily.
Yeah, it seems like you are a heroine.
Move it. Let's go, soldier boy. Move it out. Keep your legs up. Faster. Around the field. Let's go. Let's try again! Oh, look how sad I am! He can't do it!
your student organizers, Carmen Ferreira, and I would like to thank you for showing up in such prodigious numbers. Now we'll need as many female volunteers as possible for practice for the role-playing session.
And free juice boxes to anybody who comes.
Stay strong, ladies.
Let's go, Benjamin. You're coming with me. Keep moving. I'm wasting my time. You're disrespecting me. Let's go. Let's go. What is your problem?
Had enough, Benjamin?
I wasn't making fun of gays. I'm just trying to help Freddy Gong realize he is gay.
Shut your trap and give me 500 more. Here's a special treat. Put your face in it. Oh, boy, I love that movie. Popcorn, sitting at home. Great flick.
I could be at Roscoe's right now.
Enjoying a nice big plate of fried chicken and waffles. I would rather be massaging Bioglass's feet than being held prisoner at this ridiculous camp.
I should be with my dad, hauling in a 20-pound bass we spent an hour wrestling with. My mom would fillet it, season it, and grill it to perfection.
Oh, God, what I wouldn't give.
Deny Mama anymore. She's been waiting a long time for these.
Mary, what are you doing? Are you planning the session or... Wait, is that Joe? Naked as a jaybird!
What about your manifesto?
Oh, honey, I can't be a feminist. I wax.
Oh, shoot! God, I wish this fog would clear.
Oh, my God. Is that Sugar Daddy's butt? Mary Cherry, you are from Planet Perv.
Okay, question my intergalactic origins all you want, hun. But listen, I've looked at Joe's feet and I know he's packing.
Okay, you know what? I have to turn you in, because this is wrong.
No, wait. Carmen, wouldn't you like to know everything there is to know about the mysterious, the debonair Josh?
Get rid of that fog, Mary Cherry. Okay.
What in the name of Bob Vila is going on here?
It's her fault. She slipped me a roofie. No, I didn't do anything. I'm innocent.
No, you're guilty. Guilty of the same sexual objectification they are. Consider yourselves my newest recruits.
Oh, great, Carmen. Thank you.
Shut up.
Well, if it isn't Lily of the Valley.
Look, Nicole, I know I can't convince you that I had nothing to do with your imprisonment. But it wasn't my fault.
Oh, I think it was.
And I certainly know there's no way to convince you of my straightness.
That's for sure.
I'd like to make a deal.
What could you possibly have to offer?
Retribution. Against your true enemies.
Guys, did you see them out there?
I almost felt bad for them.
Yeah, almost. But remember, no pain, no gain, right?
Hey, right. What's Freddy Gong doing here?
McQueen! McPherson! Apparently you're not as sweet and innocent as we all thought you were! Seems you have a few offenses of your own to answer for! Report to active duty immediately! Fall in!
Harassment is an equal opportunity employer. It knows no gender lines. Now, drop and give me 50! Push-ups! Except for you, G.I. Jane. You're doing them Jack Palance style. This is pathetic! Don't you disrespect my mats! Kiss the mat!
Michael, what twisted and psychotic lies did you tell to get us thrown in here? What did you say to Freddy?
What do you call those? Those aren't push-ups!
Fine, Johnny won't sing. We'll get the truth.
Yeah, count it, sister. I hate this. I feel like I could just kill somebody.
up, down, up, down. Where'd you learn that?
You gotta get me out of here. There's a rumor going around that Mary Cherry plans to shiv me in the laundry room. Tonight, 10 o'clock.
No sleep for you tonight, Benjamin. Instead, you will watch Philadelphia, Johnny Demme's seminal examination of homophobia on an endless loop. You will empathize with tolerance, Benjamin!
She's still after me?
Look, we know you made a deal. We just want to know what you told her.
This is why you dragged me here? Well, forget about it. What I said to Nicole is none of your business. You took the control away. All I've done is take it back.
Freddie, we are innocent.
Are you?
Yes.
Look, I had to stop her. And this deal was my best bet. I'm sorry, guys, but you started this.
Identify yourself!
I'm the night janitor.
I see. Sick him, Julie! Sick him!
What?
Oh my God! Oh my God! Thanks,
you! Ms. Janitor! You. This attempt, in addition to showing a stunning lack of creativity, is evidence of your apathy to your jailbreaker's crimes! Report to the barracks! Immediately! Both of you!
Man. Sorry.
Okay.
Gentlemen, now that your bodies are sufficiently bruised, the time has come to break your spirits. The walk of shame. Simply walk from one end of the hallway to the other. The girls have been instructed to toss back every lewd comment they've ever heard. Open wide, boys, as you're about to get a big honking taste of what the other side is like! You. Go.
One of you budding Emily Post has proclaimed your innocence louder than a Jerry Bruckheimer summer demolition derby, I've decided an exam is in order. Number one, are you guilty of sexual harassment? I see. Have you ever touched a boy against his wishes? Alrighty then. Have you ever purposefully exposed yourself to a boy? There are clinics for people like you, Cherry. Have you ever discussed a boy's physical appearance in such a way that might make another boy uncomfortable?
Oh, wow.
You know what I just realized? Josh has a muffin butt.
Yeah, it's like two puppies romping under a blanket.
Really?
I see. And have any of you ever admired media portrayals of the male physique, which was readily apparent to other boys?
Now this is what a boy should look like.
Look at that stomach.
Oh my God,
he's so cute.
Ladies, I have just one more question. Are any of you guilty of sexual harassment?
I gotta admit, I feel violated.
Just think, man. They go through that every day.
Oh, come on, guys. That was a gross exaggeration.
Tom Hanks won an Oscar for that. And yet, why do Bruce Springsteen's songs all sound the same?
Chow time is over. Boys, report to my sister's class immediately! As for you, Benjamin, you forced my hand. Looks like I'll have to do something special to teach you a little respect!
Why can't you just admit I'm too strong? I'm innocent of any wrongdoing, and if I have to walk over fiery hot coals from hell to prove it, so be it.
Funny you should say that, Benjamin. Before we begin our last exercise, Mr. Ford!
Sir, yes, ma'am.
You have a visitor in the hallway, and be quick about it! What are you looking at, Pop-Tart?
Josh.
Mom, what's going on? Why are you here?
Josh, the trip, it didn't work out.
Mom, just wait for me to be done, okay? We can talk about this. We can figure something out.
No, it's too late, Josh. I won't go on being this unhappy. I am sorry, I have to move out.
Mom, what are you gonna do, get a job? You haven't worked in years. How are you gonna survive?
Well, I'll figure it out. I've already found a place. It's not huge, but it's everything we need. It's got two bedrooms.
Wait, you want me to move in with you?
Well, of course.
I have a room, Mom, at home, in our house. You wanna move out, give up? Fine, but I won't do that. Ever!
Mr. John! Pretend Miss McPherson is your girlfriend! Now! Imagine you're about to go on a great big date! What would you like her to be wearing? She's a real pretty girl, bro. A hottie.
I know what you think I'm going to say, being a horrible guy and all. Not gonna do it, sir.
Oh, come on, bro. Don't be a shaking, frightened, politically correct little wimp boy. This is about honesty.
Okay, fine, fine. All guys, honestly, want their girls to look like girls. So I'd say, a nice dress, sir.
What kind? Do I have a good deal with a boom boom room?
Being honest? Yeah. Yeah, a little cleavage is good. A little leg, too.
Guys want this?
Yes, sir.
Now, Sam, how does that make you feel?
Sleazy, like a whore. I don't like it.
Harrison! Imagine Sam's all gussied up and about to leave on her date! Got it? Good! Now imagine she's your kid sister. The baby sister you held in your arms. An innocent, never been corrupted. Are you still there?
Yeah. I mean, maybe not. No, I guess I wouldn't want my sister to—
What's changed, bro? They're both women, aren't they? Your turn, Sam! Harrison, turn around! Sam, what do you think of Daddy's rear hair? Is it nice,
firm, hot!
I don't know. I wouldn't judge something like that. Okay, it's cute. It's muffin-y.
Thanks for being honest.
Now grab it!
What?
Touch it!
No!
Do it! Squeeze this, Charmin, or you come back next week!
No, that is not fair. You're taking away my choice. No!
Exactly! Recognize that feeling. That's what harassment is all about! Taking away somebody's choice not to be touched! Taking away somebody's choice to be left alone! You! You! Get up here! Mr. Ford! This is the girl you objectified! Imagine she's wearing the same outfit she was that morning and repeat what you said to her!
Damn, where you been hiding those?
Lily, tell Josh how you feel!
Uncomfortable. Humiliated and objectified.
Anything else?
Powerless. I felt...
Spit it out!
I felt ashamed and I felt dirty.
Mr. Ford made you feel that way?
Yes.
Come on, Lily. You're just spitting out that PC crap you've been eating for breakfast. I was only saying something that would flatter any normal girl. You should feel good about yourself.
Let's try this again, Mr. Ford. Only this time in place of Lily. Imagine it's your mother you're speaking to.
My mother?
That's right! She's a normal girl, isn't she? In place of Lily, imagine it's your mother. And go ahead! Make her feel good about herself!
Somebody finally having an epiphany?
Lily, why don't you admit what's really going on? You wanted a little male attention, and that's why you wore that outfit.
Why should I have to defend myself? I was the victim here.
I am so sick and tired of hearing this victim crap. I did exactly what you were hoping for. I noticed you. And now you've dragged me and everyone else into this useless weekend. A weekend I should be spending with my family. But thanks to you, I probably don't even have a family. And if that wasn't enough, you had to go and poison your friends' minds as well. Look, I don't know what your problem is, Lily. Maybe you're bitter, maybe you're insecure. God, maybe you just can't take a compliment, I don't know. But I did nothing wrong. Listen, okay, just deal with it. It's not like I hit you.
You know what's scary, Josh? You're behaving exactly like your father.
Wait, I'm sorry. Lily, I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
At ease, Private. Pack your bags. You're discharged.
That's it? That's all you got? I told you no one could break me. I win. I always win.
That's one way to look at it. You're a strong girl, Miss Julian. Strongest recruit I've ever encountered. It's unfortunate you have nowhere to channel that energy. You'd make a great leader. It's too bad you're all alone with no one to lead.
Hey, Lil.
Hey.
You know, I saw you coming into school this morning. I was gonna tell you something, but I couldn't. I wanted to tell you that you looked cute, but I didn't know if that would be okay or not, so. Is it?
I think so. Yes. Yeah, you can tell me that I look cute.
Okay.
It's really complicated, right? I mean, I know that you're my friend, and I know that you weren't trying to hurt me.
But I did. I'm sorry. Well, you should be able to wear whatever you want.
I know, but maybe I was trying to get some attention.
But not like that.
The thing is where do you draw the line? I mean, is it at you look cute or pretty or hot, sexy?
I don't know.
I think it's different for everyone. That's what makes it so hard.
All by yourself, I see.
What do you want, Nicole? I thought we had an agreement.
We do. I just noticed that you always seem to eat alone. It's not such a great feeling, is it?
No. No, it isn't.
I'm sorry.
Thanks.
Got an extra room for rent?